Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
In the linked list, operations on the linked list, and yesterday we talked about the modify. So, okay, so now we know how to create the linked list and how to view the linked list. Yesterday we talked about the modify operation, and in the modify we learned that how to update the existing value. But when we say that I want to modify the linked list, it can be the insertion of the new node, of the new value, right? Update means what? That some value is there and you are just updating it, right? You are just replacing it with the new value. But when we say modify, it means I can also insert the value in the linked list. So when we say the insertion operation, we call it insertion operation. So insertion operation is very important. The reason is there are three different places where you can insert the new node. So that we are going to talk in this session, that which are these three places where we can insert the node. So let's say that let me first draw the linked list. Is it visible, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you do it with me in your notebook. Do the same thing. Narendra is not there today in the meeting.
And I am here.
Okay. Okay. So this is our simple singly linked list. And if I asked you to perform the insertion operation, insertion operation. So three places where you can add the node. The first is at the start, means the first node. Second, middle. Middle means anywhere. And the third is end. So when we say that insert the node at the starting point, insert the node in the middle of the middle means any location, in between means. And the last scenario is at the end. So now, when you will ask to the user to modify the linked list, now again give the two options. Or what other thing you can do? Create is one there, and also you can add the new operation here. Create, insert, modify. Understood? This you can do. Create, insert, and modify or update. This way you can do. So create we know, modify we have already done, and insert we are learning today. Okay, so where you can insert? You can insert at the end, you can insert in between, and you can insert the node at the end. So when you ask to the user, if suppose user is selecting this operation, insert operation, again ask to the user, Where do you want to insert the new node? Understood, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Getting me? So what will happen now that let's say that user said, okay, let's say that insert this second option chosen by the user. Now ask, where do you want to insert the new node? Again, give the choice: one, start, or the beginning. At the beginning, second, in between, ya to fir like in the middle or anywhere. And like in between ka matlab hoga after or before. And this after and before can be your location, like at the fourth location, at the fifth location, that way. And third is at the end. And again, enter your choice here. Choice now. User will enter any one choice over here. So we will have three different scenarios for all these three operations. I'll show you that what is the logic for all these three operations. Is this clear, everyone?
Yes.
Okay. So let's start with the first operation, that is at the beginning. The first is, let's say user is saying the first at the beginning. So what would be the logic? See, the logic is, what I need to do, I'm planning to add the node over here, right? So if I say that I want to create the node over here, it means, okay, let's say this is the node, and let's say the address is, let's say the address is 2001 is the address. Now, what I want to do, this is my new node, guys. This will be the new node.
Yes.
Okay. So let's say this is my temp. The address of this here in the temp. So at the time of the creation, this will point this. Now, what I want to do, okay, here we have the partition. It is, okay. So first, what I want to do, I want, start, ST, what is happening? Okay, ST is equal to 10. Can I write this statement? My first logic, ST is equal to temp, means the value of the temp I want to assign in the ST. What will happen in that case? Temp has 2001 and this value will be assigned to the ST. So now my ST will be 2001 and immediately it will point this node, right? Okay, now I want to store the new value. Let's say whatever the user has entered, ST info is equal to, let's say value, any value, and let's say the value user has entered 60. So 60 will be assigned here. Now what I want to do, the one mistake that normally students do is they write this statement first. So now you can see that how will I get this to 1001, right? How will I get this 1001? Because I want to link this node. I want to create the link over here. So do not do this mistake before this statement. Earlier it was. So before writing this statement, write down this temp next is equal to st. So now the temp next means this location means 1001, and this will point this, right? And after that you can write this statement. So this will be 2001, and this ST will point to this node. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the logic, like first this, the address of the star should be assigned to the temp's next, then the value of the temp will be assigned to the ST, then the value. Simple. So only three statements will be there, and this index will be automatically changed. It will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. We don't need to do anything for this indexing. It will automatically create the index. So this is for the start or the this at the first node or at the beginning. Clear, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Any doubt, any query?
No, ma'am.